team.
What makes CBA soccer such a consistent powerhouse is that, you know, there's an expectation to be the best, and I think you just also get a consistent group of guys who all love the game, they love each other, and like it's literally a brotherhood. So I think that's something that no matter what players we have, that'll always be part of the team, because that's just part of what CBA soccer is.
It's a great honor to put on the CBA jersey, because not every kid gets to make it and only 20 get the spot. So it's just a great privilege to even wear the jersey and be on that team. So you just got to enjoy every moment of it.
Yes, definitely. If you have CBA across your chest, I mean, just, you know, feeling part of that team, part of that community, it's awesome. People hold us to higher standards than most schools, so you really feel like you're special.
To be part of the CBA program, I really do feel like it's an honor, just because, like, so many people try out. And it would just be like, I'm just so grateful to be able to have the chance to play with them.
Some people wonder why, since I didn't get selected, I still decided to come back to support the team. And it's pretty much because all these guys have been my best friends since freshman year.
There's no camaraderie like you get here at CBA, especially on the soccer team. There's like such a deep, rich history.
If I were to go back on my time at CBA, like in total, just not about soccer, just in total, I think every great memory I've had at CBA is my top five memories at CBA is something to do with the soccer season. So I just think it like how special the team is every year I've been on it.
One of the things that I'll remember walking away from this program is the friendships that I've made, and those friendships that will last a lifetime. Nothing replaces that brotherhood that you form in the CBA soccer program.
I've never been a part of a team that has this creative chemistry. I mean, everybody loves each other. Like we hang out, we always love hanging out, and I think the best part about this program is just us being together. This is my favorite part of CBA, and I'm gonna miss it a lot.
The fact that we had chemistry off the field as friends made our chemistry on the field just much more achievable.
I think everybody felt it, especially every time we got together. There was just this happy energy. Everybody was really just happy to be with each other, and we enjoyed each other's presence a lot. It was like a real fun group of kids, a lot of characters. I also think we were a hard-working group of kids. We wanted to push each other a little bit.
Coming into the season, we knew that our attacking trio was going to be dangerous, and there was a lot of press coverage on us three, but the MVPs of our team were indisputably our back line and Charlie Paparella playing the six.
Well, me, Max, Christian, and Larry, we were part of the back four that let in 7 goals, and I'm going to give credit to the midfield too, Chuck, Logan, Dimitri. Everyone put in the same work. Defensively, everyone got back. But yeah, the four of us in the back, it was an experience like no other. I've never been a part of such a defense like that before.
We all knew that we didn't really get the recognition, and we were kind of okay with that, because we got the recognition from our teammates, just not, we didn't get all like the press and all that stuff. But we all just, before every game, same thing, let's get another clean sheet. There's no way we lose if we get a clean sheet. It's not possible. So that relationship with them, it's just awesome, because we were a brick wall and it was so fun, and it was the best defense I think I've ever seen. I think the most underrated player this year has to be Logan Swalski. I feel like when he goes in the game, everything just calms down. He's like a reliable source. You play him the ball, you know he's not going to lose it. His touch never goes more than like an inch from his foot. And I think that's something that just everywhere in soccer gets a little undervalued, because it's not as flashy.
I think we obviously, like, if you were to watch one of our games, people would notice like me and Will's speed on the side and are like how dangerous our attack is, but like no one would really understand like how important our defense was. We won multiple games this year, like 4 or 5 games, 1-0.
I'm so proud of my midfield. I mean, I think the most underrated player on the team, one of them, one besides, I think the defense is completely underrated. Max and Christian were really one of the biggest parts of the defense, and they were huge, but I think Charlie's very underappreciated, you know, but he really just held down that midfield. He was a rock. You could always count on it. And Dimitri, he had tons of assists, and he would always win it in there.
Dimitri Korba, he's just like a beast. Like, he's always bumping into people. He's always winning balls. He's always playing, like, perfect through balls, and he's just like the definition of a top class player. Like, you see him do things that you wouldn't expect anyone but a pro to do.
I think we were very, very like glued together, and our chemistry was great, and it really helped the, just not only helped the defense, but it also helped translate to the attack.
Jack Little's goal in the short conference semi was ridiculous, just because, from my view, it was like one of the best goals I had ever seen.
I knew I had to make something happen. So with about 3 minutes left, I'd say, I kind of said to myself, like, next time I get the ball at my feet, I'm going to goal, and I'm going to score. And then my time came, minute 30 left, I got the ball dribbled in, just no thoughts in my mind, just ripped the shot.
My favorite part of the season had to be Will Tigerson's game winner in the state final, because before the game, he said that if we held the other team to zero goals, that we would definitely win.
And Will, once again, performs under pressure and delivers that promise to everyone and puts the ball in the back of the net.
So walking through the final goal in my head, I think about how we were kind of struggling to just get that final piece and score that goal. And Dimitri played a great ball through, and it was kind of a surreal moment running down the field, hearing the fans scream and cheer, and just watching that ball roll into the net was one of the best feelings ever. Very surreal moment, and obviously when you watch the video, the reaction of everybody, it was a great moment, one that I'll always remember.
I was telling everybody next to me, my legs were shaking, my body was shaking, I couldn't keep it under control. It was everything I ever wanted.
Right after the game, right after Will scored, I remember running straight up to him, and I was like, "You did it, dude. Like, this is what you live for."
We didn't know what to think. Like, we were still like in shock. We were just running around with like flying emotions. We didn't know what to think. It was pretty unbelievable.
One of our captains, Will, said that he wouldn't rather be out here with any other group of guys. He knew that he might have been the goal scorer against Seton Hall, but he knew that each of us had a vital role to play in.
I literally just fell to my knees. I was so happy. I think I hugged Max. Me and Max fell to the ground, and a bunch of the team just all like dogpiled onto us. And it was really just like a feeling like no other.
I remember after the game, Christian coming up to me and me going up to him and hugging him, and it was just kind of like, finally, there's no doubt, we're the best. We're the best defense, we're the best offense, we're the best team in the entire state. And it was just kind of felt like just a culmination of all those expectations.
When I walked off the field after our state final, everyone, of course, was thrilled we just won. But I do remember looking down at my jersey and seeing, like, the last time I'm ever going to wear that CBA number 7. And it kind of just, like, I would think I'd be, like, very, like, kind of, like, emotional because it was my last game. But it kind of just, like, brought together, like, happiness because, like, how, like, all that I've accomplished, all the team's accomplished, just looking down at the CBA uniform one last time and taking it off, it just kind of puts together everything we've accomplished. So it was a really good feeling.
When you get to the top, like we did especially, it's like, this is a group of guys you remember forever. This is like, this is the group I'll take away from high school more than any other group, because it's something that I achieved with them after months of struggle and perseverance.
Putting on that jersey, like knowing what past teams have been through, knowing what past players have done, just putting us on that jersey, like you're wearing legacy, basically.
So I think the bench's energy actually helped the starters tremendously, because we gave it our all every single practice. We knew we had to give them a challenge because they would see that challenge in the game. So us giving them like 50% effort doesn't help them. Going 110% always every day is what made them great. Is what made those starters on the field the best team in the state.
I will miss just about everything about this soccer program, from the practices to the games to the bus rides to just hanging out with the guys outside of a school environment. I don't believe that there's any soccer program in the state like this program. I don't believe there's a coaching staff in the state like this program. And I don't believe that there's a brotherhood in the state like this program.